It can be hard to know where to start with your trademark specifications. Maybe you don't even know what that means. You won't be the first and you definitely won't be the last, so let's go over and see what you need to know. All trademarks are registered for a list of goods and services. This is also known as a specification. So, when you're crafting your trademark specification, it's important to include a list of all the goods and services that you might be using your trademark for. Think about what goods or services you're providing to customers and what your business is known for. Your specification is a key part of your trademark application as it ultimately defines the scope of protection if your trademark application is successful. Similar goods and services are grouped into 45 classes. Goods are grouped in class 1 to 34, and services are classes from 35 to 45. When it comes to writing your specification, there's help available. Check out the TM Specification Builder on the IPONS website. The builder allows you to research and create your specifications before you start an application. There are over 60,000 pre-approved goods and services terms, so the good news is that you can write your own, but you don't need to. Say you own a business that manufactures materials for making and decorating cakes, that also runs workshops for how to bake cakes. You can search for any and all keywords that could cover your business. In this example, keywords could be cakes, decorations, food, workshops, utensils, anything along those lines. Let's take a look at the builder. Click on Search for Terms. You'll be taken to a section where you can enter the terms we mentioned earlier. As you can see, cake gives all these suggested terms and tells us what class they're in. Class 30 is for products derived from flours and grains. So if you're making cakes and putting your trademark on the packaging, you would select this class. If you also make icing and other similar food products, you can select the relevant class for that as well. To see all options in this class, click on Show More. After you select terms, they are moved over to the right side. If you've selected a term, but you've decided that actually doesn't fit your business, just remove it by clicking on the minus sign. Scroll down the results of your search, and you'll see that Class 21 includes kitchen utensils. As Class 21 is also a goods class, you should think about whether you'll be selling kitchen utensils. If you're not making them and putting your brand on them, you probably don't need to protect kitchen utensils. If you're selling kitchen utensils that other companies make, either through your workshop or storefront, you may want to select retail and wholesale services for kitchen utensils and containers in Class 35 as a service you offer. As you look further through the list of terms, some of these options will not be relevant to your business, such as Class 3, which refers to cakes of soap and the likes. Simply ignore the results unless they apply to your particular business. You can repeat your search using other keywords like workshop, which brings up Class 41, conducting workshops, which in this case you would select as a core part of your business. We've only searched for two terms in this example, but you will want to search for all your keywords to find all terms that may be relevant to your business. If you need a bit of inspiration to see what classes could be relevant to your trademark application, you could even search the IPONS register to see what competitors have selected for their specifications to protect their trademark under. Now that you have your shortlist to the right, you can select Next and save your specification so you've got it ready to upload when you're submitting your trademark application. Save a copy as a PDF file to share with your team or legal counsel. Save as an XML file to upload later for your trademark application. It's best to get advice from an intellectual property professional if you're not sure what terms to choose for your specification, or if you want to write your own. You can't generally make changes to your application after you've submitted it, so think about it carefully before you apply. Okay, let's talk cost. A trademark application made using pre-approved terms is $70 per class plus GST. In our example, we chose three classes, so that takes the total to $210 plus GST. When it comes time to make your application, it'll help to be familiar with the Specification Builder tool, as a version of the builder is available on the application form, allowing you to either build your specification from scratch or upload one you've saved earlier as an XML file. Still have questions? The Intellectual Property Office of New Zealand is open between 8:30 a.m. and 5 p.m. Monday to Friday. For less urgent matters, you can head to the Contact Us page on the IPONS website. We should be in touch within 7 working days. The Contact Us page also has a common queries section, so be sure to check this out in case it addresses your question or concern.